Go.
Sir, you gotta get your hands off me.
Go.
You guys, please. I just got here, and when I walked up to the building, they said, are you Zach Hubbard? And they said, you're not allowed here, and this guy just put hands on me. What's your name?
Leave.
What's your name?
What's your name?
You just asked me my name.
Leave.
Tell me what my name is. Just ask me it.
Hey, Pat, can you come out?
Pat's coming out, you guys. We got hands on here.
All right, come on.
Whoa.
Press Pat.
Hey, man, you got a road.
Hold on.
You gotta go.
What do I have to roll for?
You gotta roll.
Trespass.
Come on.
You gotta trespass. You're gonna be.
You gotta go, man.
This is private property.
Hold on.
Come on, partner. You gotta go.
Hey, you don't need to put hands on.
What is it?
Now let's go.
Listen.
This way, brother.
Listen.
This way. Listen. This way.
I can walk. You don't need to put hands on.
Okay, then. Let's go.
Trader Pat.
I'm Pat. Yeah.
Okay. So Pat's gonna put hands on.
Let's go.
You know. Listen. Please don't push me. I will walk.
Well, then walk.
I don't. Hey, I'm happy to walk. I just don't need to be pushed.
Start walking.
Huh?
Start walking.
Okay, what law did I violate coming here?
Start walking, man. Let's go.
Do you know why I'm here?
Yeah,
I'm
I know.
For the actual victims.
Well, let's go.
Why am I here, sir?
Man, go, man.
Go.
Get on my nerve. Go. Let's go.
Why am I getting on your nerve?
Come on, man.
Let's roll.
Let's roll.
Arrested for trespassing. That's it.
What law did I break?
Trespassing.
You're talking too much, man. Let's go. Let's go, man. You talk too much.
Where am I supposed to go? I'm off the property.
Yeah.
I'm off the property.
You're good. You can go anywhere. You're off the property. Off the
property. Stay off of this. Stay off of this.
I'm going to sell out to the man again.
I didn't want to go to jail if I didn't have to come back to court. But okay. court will be a problem. So. Well, I appreciate your honesty and for you coming out and giving me the information and the phone number.
Yes, thank you. We decided to make the trip on Friday night to come to Oklahoma City after we saw how Zachary was unjustly treated at the Oklahoma City Memorial Museum. They wouldn't let him in. He was harassed and assaulted by the security guards. So once we got there, just visiting the area, I immediately felt an energy pull from that fence area that they had moved there and the story that's behind it and all of the personal items that have been placed along this fence. And I started to look around. Zachary was pointing out to us how there's the Masonic building right directly behind the museum, the AT&T building across. It's also across from a post office, a fire station, a federal building. They're right there watching us the whole time. They had their eyes on Zachary the entire time. They knew he was coming and they threatened him. But there were truth seekers coming from all over the country on the way to be reinforcement for Zachary. That Saturday evening, after we left the memorial area, we ventured off into downtown OKC through Bricktown and stopped at Toby Keith's restaurant and had some drinks and got to know each other better. The atmosphere in that place was really great. It was a nice, fun country bar. We enjoyed some live music, met a lot of smiling faces. He was able to engage with people at the bar. It was wonderful.
Happy Saturday!
art and Americana and Toby Keith memorabilia. We enjoyed it. And shout out to Native OKC Truth Seeker Corey for the recommendation of Toby Keith's. We really enjoyed it.
His statue fell on June 19, 2020 after the George Floyd riots, right? Mm-hmm. Let me put all this together. Let's actually go back to George Floyd. So George Floyd, his full name, George Perry Floyd, is gematria equals 201. We're going to just call it this whole 201 number. So his death was compared to a David Traore's death in Paris, France, which created something similar over there.
Okay.
David Traore was killed on the 201st day of 2016, exactly 201 weeks before George Floyd, right? Now, 201 is the number of the Jesuits who are from Paris, France, which is where David Traore was killed, right? So, right after the George Floyd thing, you have these protests throughout the nation, right? Statues get toppled. So the Albert Pike statue comes down, the only Confederate statue in D.C. From the day that statue fell to the insurrection, it's 201 days later, right? 201. The word Confederate is 201. That's the only Confederate statue in D.C. Lincoln gave a speech about, you know, the Civil War would have never happened if it wasn't for the sinister influence of the Jesuits.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I can tell you, there's a reason.
I'm going to be picking your mind this whole weekend, so.
Yeah, you ain't going to. So look at this. So all this 201 stuff, right? So now let's go over to what happened at Oklahoma City. So Timothy McVeigh, his name equals 201. Terry Lynn Nichols is a cop.
See the response.
What day is he sentenced to death? June 13, 97. The day he was 201 days left in the year. He's arrested in a story that doesn't make any sense. He didn't want to be caught, but then he goes and drives on the interstate in a car with no plates. So why would he have The name of that car was a Mercury Marquis, which equals 201, right? And mercury on the periodic table is the only element that has an atomic mass of 201, right?
Holy
but mercury
shit.
In Roman mythology is the trickster, right? So they put Timothy McVeigh to death right before 9/11. 9/11 happened at the time of Virgo, which is ruled by Mercury. And there were two towers that became zero, that became one, right? 201.
Yep.
And I don't know if you know this, but they simulated the 9/11 attack on June 1st, 2001 with Operation Mountain Virgo. You know about that?
I've heard of that, but I don't know.
Look up Operation Mountain Virgo. It's still on the government website. The PDF, the cover sheet is Osama bin Laden's face. But it's a simulation of Al-Qaeda attacking the nation with cruise missiles. And they simulated exactly 102 days before 9/11. And they say the 9/11 attack lasted 102 minutes, which is just a reflection of 201, right? And the text Art of War, which is translated by a Jesuit father on the eye, otherwise we wouldn't even know about it.
Really?
There's no evidence that a Sun Tzu ever existed. The only reason we know about that text is because the father on the eye, the Jesuit priest. And what's his name? Sun Tzu? What's the Jesuit slogan? The Sun. They serve a Catholic church that worships on Sunday. But again, 102, 201, they go nuts with these numbers.
Mm-hmm.
And you start to look at it, you start to realize, man, we are living out just like a planned agenda throughout time where they keep doing the same damn thing over and over. And now you realize, it's like, okay, so Timothy McVeigh, this white supremacist terrorist, and now how are they... And think about it. So they introduced... I mean, this... When that happened in 95, I mean, that scared a lot of people. Like, we hadn't really had anything like that. So we just blowing up a huge bomb, destroying, you know? So they do that in 95.
Yeah, right, The Matrix and Fake Mike Real News met up with Zachary, and we had an evening full of great conversation, good vibes. The energy was amazing. By the end of the night, our waiter wanted to know what we were talking about. We hooked him up with the Gematria gang. We told him where he could find more information. The bartender was curious about Zachary's books. There was a group of people at the bar that wanted to know what was going on. We were starting to spread the word around Oklahoma. And day two was coming up on Sunday, Easter Sunday, and we were ready to pound pavement.
Personal with Robin Leach, and I'm far from
cheap. I smoke soap with my peeps all day. Spread love is the Brooklyn way. The Moet and Allen, they keep me busy. Girls used to diss me. Now they write letters cause they miss me. I never thought it could happen, this rapping stuff. I was too used to packing gets and stuff. Now honeys play me close like butter plates. We used to fuck when the landlord dissed
us.
No heat,
wonder
why Christmas missed us. Birthdays was the worst days. Now we sip champagne when we thirsty.
That's
where they make Buicks? And if you don't know, now you know.
That's
where
the original.
And if you don't know, now you know.
Is that museum open, I wonder?
Somebody from Texas.
Sunday?
What do you need a vaccine when you don't know the side effects of it all?
Not even a vaccine.
80-20 rule, 80% of your time. Try to do good, 20%, live your life.
This experience for me though just reminds me of the Catholic Church, Masons, and it's just like, look at this site. The Masonic temple's on the other side of the building. Catholic Church is right there. And then the other thing I always talk about is AT&T in 1968, what they did. And it's like, you look it up. When I first got here, I was like, wow, the AT&T building's right here. And then you look it up and you're like, man, that building turned 68 years old when this thing blew up.
Oh, wow.
And again, the guy who wrote the book, who inspired Timothy McVeigh to supposedly do this, he died at 68. His birthday just happens to be September 11th. And they put Timothy McVeigh to death right before 9/11. And we know in 1968, that's when AT&T made 9/11 passes in that boat. World Trade Center construction again. George W. Bush graduated from Yale to Seton Hall. And of course, that's what this is. Like, what in the world? And you know, from the governor at the time. From his birthday to this explosion was 68 days. He went to Georgetown like Clinton, who was the president then. And then, I mean, you look at this. They got the sculpture down here, the Jesus Weep sculpture. Yeah. Did you look at that?
I need to go look at that.
Yeah, we just walked around.
Should we walk down as a group?
And I've been following his work since like 2013.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. And at first, I was kind of like a horse with like blinders on. I only wanted to believe in what I wanted to believe. You know, yeah. I'm like, numbers, you know, meaning anything. I'm like, it's basically, you know, bull, but there's a lot of truth and relevance to what he says.
Indeed.
Because that pretty much, I got it through sports, you know, with the Cubs winning the World Series, because that was the 112th World Series, and when it concluded, it was November, the 11th month, and second day. So that's 112, makes you with the 112 World Series. I'm like, man, you're right. It just opens up your eyes and your ears. It's never been more open. You know, it's like they live. When you put on those glasses, you're able to, you know, see everything for what it is.
Right.
It's just, it's crazy. But crazy in a great way. Because, you know, if more people were awake to this stuff, you know, you have strength in numbers.
Indeed.
Indeed.
feet again. Flooded when you prayed for rain, you prayed for rain. The well's running dry. Hell, so am I. I won't give up this time, not this time.
The more we walked around the area, it was evident that this area was a major energetic vortex. We decided to stop and look at a local church that was right beyond the statue. They were still having their Easter Sunday service.
There's so many of us. There's strength in numbers. We hire a couple of lawyers, and constitutional lawyers, and some bosses.
Right.
We can change that like that. It won't take that long.
The club, Truth Gangsters, field trip day. When we question the lies and search for the truth, we shift the power so justice can prevail. When we search for truth and expose the lies, we create a space for inevitable change. In times of darkness, you can be a spark of light. It was a beautiful Sunday, and Sunset Patio Bar was the perfect place for truth seekers to come and meet up. It had a 90s vibe with a positive atmosphere, and there was plenty of great conversation to be had.
This has to be the 90s on Night Station. I've heard all 90s songs.
Yeah, but it was just so weird because. Well, that was the year of the Astros Dodgers. And they had a 33-74 ritual in the game. And then I was just connecting all the stuff. I was connected to Jesus. I even brought in with Tupac. And then so the next day, Jensen comes back out, and Joe Buck is coming out. He's like, they're blasting Tupac. And I was like, wait, you watch my video last night? He's saying that as he's coming out to the mound right now.
Olympic Games opening ceremony.
They were doing the TikTok dances in Olympic in 2000. Yes, they fucking did the simulation in 2012. They were fucking dancing just like the TikTok videos in 2012 with the fucking masks.
April 19th is super important to the Jesuits, who are the military order of the Catholic Church. And the reason they like that date is because that's the day Ignatius of Loyola, their founder, became the first superior general recognized by the Catholic Church to lead their military. So, in gematria, if you spell out his name, Ignatius of Loyola, that equals 201, right? Right now we're living in the time of the first ever Jesuit pope, and he's the founder of the Jesuits. Pope Francis is the first Jesuit pope. His first name is Jorge Mario Bergoglio, which equals 201. He's the first pope to ever live in Suite 201 at the Vatican. First ever to live in Suite 201. We look into the Jesuit history. They were saved by Catherine the Great in Russia, who preserved the order with 201 Jesuits. They would have been ended without her. That's their history. But what's interesting is if you spell out Timothy McVeigh, 201, right? Were you guys in the military? Your military personnel file is called a 201 file. That's what it's called. 201 file. Again, Jesuits are military order. And they run this nation, and the Jesuits have been in D.C. longer than the federal government. The land was gifted from a Jesuit name. It's an independent city-state since 1871, since the end of the Civil War, and it's run by the Jesuits. It seems coincidental, but I'm going to tell you why it's not a coincidence. Both parking garages on both sides of the memorial are 6'8". You'll see the clearance, 6'8". Again, that's something like 68. Like I was telling you how the plan went to motion in 68. That AT&T building that overlooks the memorial site, that building turned 68 years old in 95. AT&T is who made 911 the emergency dialing code in 68. When that building exploded, it was exactly 68 days after the governor's birthday. Timothy McVeigh was supposedly inspired by the author who wrote the book The Turner Diaries. His birthday is September 11th, and he died at age 68. And I'm forgetting a few other things. Oh, and gematria, Patriots Day is 68. It happened on Patriots Day. There's a lot of tragedy that happened.
Hold on, hold on. Do you even know what gematria is?
Practice code numbers in verse.
Words have a numerical value.
Okay, look. The letter A.
Hebrew.
The letter A is 1. Letter B, 2. A is C. C is 3. D is 4, right? We're talking about the alphabet, right? Basically. The letter Z is the 26th letter of the alphabet.
So it's kind of like just the code.
Timothy McVeigh.
It's just code.
201.
You ready?
Finish what I just told you.
You guys want to know more about this?
You got more than 90 seconds.
So April 19th is the day in history that Ignatius of Loyola became the first superior general of the Jesuits. Do you know what the Jesuits are? The Jesuits are the military order that serves the Catholic Church.
There are 25 AD. These motherfuckers have been running the fucking world.
How old are you?
26.
Young. Good to be young, man. You weren't even alive when that happened. You weren't even alive yet.
Unfortunately.
No, that's a good thing.
Yeah, no, it ain't good to be young, bro. It's hard to be young out here.
Is that right?
You say that, but it's hard to be young out here nowadays because the young are expected to pick up where the old left off. And the young ain't been provided the tools that the old had. The old did not look the tools for the young. The young have been trying to figure this shit out with no help.
We're here for you now.
You know what? We fucking dropped the ball. And we fucked it up.
Oh, wow.
I mean, I know you're low, but shit. Pick it up a little bit.
Hey.
But you know what?
That gotta be embarrassing.
Hey, Tom. Hold up. You're looking at an R1, man.
That guy is fucking down, bro.
He said low. That fucking guy is down, man. Hey, when I was a kid, there was this guy had a jackal truck, and I mean, his fucking... He had to, like, get on a ladder to get in his truck. You know what his license plate said? You are too low. That's what that reminded me of, the opposite.
Exactly, this shit would know him.
You are too low, bitch. Go ahead, Zach. I'm sorry.
He said, I took you on 97.
You know what's going through his mind right now? I fucking drove over 2,000 fucking miles, and these bitches wouldn't even let me walk in the door. They were waiting for my ass.
Because I do security and body work. So that's really weird.
They probably hire you, man. This security guard's pretty small. I've already got a contract. They had to bring out a
permit. If you get your permit, he will give you cash. No, for real. If you get your permit to be there, then I can actually legally represent you as a bodyguard. And I can hold off whatever they try to do.
Too,
oh, I stay strapped. Always strapped. Never caught lacking.
Okay.
I handle my shit, man. I don't play that. I do real bodyguard work. Like, I don't play that shit.
All right. So are you working? Let me come back to you.
Oh, no.
I'm just showing your symbol, man.
Oh.
He starts on my neck tattoo.
It's a marker to struggle with. It means no matter what, I'm always struggling. No matter what type of shit tries to pull me down, I'm struggling again.
You need the mark of the survival.
Yeah, really.
Thank you.
for you?
I'm Gypsy, Gematria Gypsy.
Okay. Yeah. What? Are you really a friend here? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Architecture in the building was something to behold. There was Jesuit symbolism everywhere. When I did ask some of the church members if they knew what the symbolism represented, they all claimed to not know. So it was interesting to come into a church on Easter Sunday and show them where all the Easter eggs were hidden in plain sight. I hope that some of them go and do some research. We were told that the original windows of this building were destroyed and replaced with the stained glass windows that you see here. The church had amazing architecture. But definitely one of those things to make you go, Before we left, we had a very interesting conversation with the cop outside.
I pretty much like tackled at the museum just for trying to go, and I didn't realize it was going to happen. But then I've had a guy walk by and smacked this in my chest, and then this morning I woke up and he found my car at the hotel somehow, and he put the same thing on there. But I mean, can I really be arrested for sharing information on a megaphone?
So, again, because the memorial is private property,
if I'm not on the property,
if you're on the sidewalk,
as far as the sidewalk, not blocking the sidewalk, obviously. Yeah. You guys, I'm assuming that you guys are familiar.
No, he was just my person.
And I can't speak to what happened over there. Obviously,
I get it. You weren't there.
I'll be there this weekend. I'll be there Tuesday. But as far as the disorderly conduct stuff, okay, you got a printout of it. It's pretty clear on that. I can tell you that from what I've seen and the instances that I've dealt with where people are out sharing their opinion, sharing information that they have in public settings, whether on private property or not,
cool.
It's
surreal, man.
It's not on us to determine if it is quote unquote disorderly conduct. In most cases, we're going to respect the right of the free speech over maybe creating some kind of disturbance. Okay? At the point that it becomes conflict, and maybe between two groups or whatever the case may be, obviously we're going to try to keep an officer distance. But, you know, I would say Oklahoma City, our department in Oklahoma, we try to do a really good job of allowing people to speak their mind in a civil way.
That's how I do it. Absolutely.
And if it gets to that point, then we'll deal with it. But, you know, we obviously 2 years ago we dealt with all the riots and all that stuff. Ours was a very quick deal. It was handled very quickly. We didn't have a day or two of it.
Wasn't it on the anniversary of the Tulsa race that happened?
Honestly, I don't remember if that it was.
It was close to it.
I mean, it was probably right there. It was probably about the same week. At least that same weekend.
I remember that now.
And so, you know, that was probably, I would assume that's the biggest incident that we've had as far as that type of civil unrest.
That was the last time being cooked up at that time all across the nation. Yep. Portland's still trashed. That's my hometown.
You remember the original riots in Tulsa?
Welcome back.
I mean, I know of them.
You know that the government was flying around with like prop dusters and dropping little bombs on the people? Well, that's history. You know that, right? Look it up.
I have a question though. I talked to another
American soil,
and she did tell me that if I use the megaphone, I will be arrested. So if somebody complains, we do have an ordinance that's making it allow this. Really, yeah, it could. I mean, but ultimately, you're going to have somebody that is going to be a complaint about that. Okay?
if it's a case of a vehicle, obviously.
Well, it's obvious that this person is stalking me, right? They even found out where my hotel is, so they're going to be the complaint. They're probably watching.
Maybe.
So
honestly, again, you're talking about stuff that as a street officer, I'm going to be riding around on a bicycle. Probably wearing.
But you're not a browser. You told us you're not a browser.
You're right. But
what you stand on that though, right?
What I'm saying is that in that case, I will probably not be the one that is doing it. I don't know who this person is that has been.
It's obviously the federal government, obviously.
It may be at the federal level.
Yeah, you're under foreign occupation. I'm telling you, this is your dirt. You're a local officer.
I don't own anything.
But you're a local officer.
That goes back to our previous.
Are you city or a county?
City.
Well, this is still your domain, right? You're gonna let a foreign entity come in here and punk you? I'm just curious. I'm just asking.
Back to our previous conversation.
I know, because you're not a brown shirt, right?
Right.
Yep. And I love you for that. You know that, right?
I appreciate
it. I will.
I'm pretty sure.
If I have to, I hope I don't. But if I had to, I would be on this hill, because that's where we're at, man. How do you feel like? Do you have children? How do you feel about them? You gotta go?
Yeah.
I'll let you go.
No, you're fine. I'll let you finish the question.
Would you let them force vaccinate your children?
No. Again, I told you I got out of the military. That's part of the reason.
We're brothers.
So, I
Revolutions was the spot. Shout out to all the truth seekers that came in from all over the country. And thank you, Zachary Hubbard, for sharing your brilliant mind with the world. We will not be silenced. Our voices will be heard. Until next time, Truth Seeker.